Shalom to all viewers across the world. I am Dr. Swane Msomi.
And I'm Dr. Tapsile Msomi.
Together, this is the atmosphere of the supernatural. This is the arena of the supernatural, where supernatural is always natural. And it is a pleasure for us to come together to have that opportunity to be in your houses, your homes, your businesses, wherever you are watching us at across the world. It's been a long time since we were together with my lovely Spupuluzana Sam, Sandra Sam, Mazondi Wami.
Amen.
We are sharing together this platform. Mm-hmm. We always like to be, because of the piece of work, we always move. But today, we are bringing you a new series. I hope you will phone my office and ask for this series, because you are going to learn a lot in it. Mm. What is it?
Yeah, it's a four-part series. That means if you watch today, we also have three other consecutive series that will be coming after, which will give you a full view, even though it's not a complete message, but it will give you an idea. Dr. Swane will be speaking about the DNA, the carrier of the genetic information. We know that every living organisms have this DNA. But today we'll be listening to him sharing to us the spiritual DNA. Have you ever wondered when people say you look exactly like your grandfather? Not only look like him, but you do exactly like him. And many people these days, they are struggling with things that they want to overcome, but it seems like they are fighting a losing battle, which is something that we obtain from our father Adam.
Exactly.
He fell and every humankind fell, but through Jesus Christ we have been redeemed.
Yes, in the beginning God said, let everything produce after its kind.
Mm-hmm.
Just remember, if before Adam fell, they had already children.
Yeah.
But their children was already in them. Mm-hmm. When they sin with
everybody
their children.
Sinned, yeah.
Everybody. When they came out with the contaminated DNA.
Mm-hmm.
But let not spill the beans.
Yeah.
But you will find it out for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Just listen to this first part of the DNA.
Amen.
You are still going to see even demonstration in coming weeks, how the DNA works in people's life. We are going to demonstrate. Enjoy the sermon.
Amen.
Bless you.
Elithi uNkulunkulu wenza yonke into.
That says God created all things.
Wathi seyenzile yonke into.
After he has created all things.
Waseyinikeza yonke into.
Then he gave all things.
Ukuthi ibe nembewu yayo.
To have its seed.
Nanokuthi iproduce ngokwembewu yayo.
And to produce according to its seed.
Ngamanye amazwi, yonke into.
In other words, all things.
Faneke iproduce ngendlela yayo.
Must produce according.
Iproduce into efana nayo.
And produce a something that is like it.
Umthetho lo uNkulunkulu awenze ekuqaleni.
That is the law that God has made in
the beginning. Wathi yonke into.
He said everything.
Ayiproduce ngendlela yayo.
Must produce after on its kind.
Lokho kusho ukuthini?
What does that mean?
Kusho ukuthi.
It means.
Nawe.
You.
Uzokhipha abafana nawe.
You will produce after your own kind.
Njengoba nawe.
As you.
Wavela kwabafana nawe.
You came from those who are like you.
Okay, angiyibeke kanje.
Let me put it in this way.
Wena.
You.
Uphuma kulabo abafana ofana nabo.
You are from the people that you are you resemble them.
Masibuka wena.
When we look at you.
Sibuka la uvela khona.
We look where you are coming from.
Abantu mabebuka abantwana bami.
When people look at my kids.
Bazongibona ukuthi nginjani.
They will see me in them.
Noma nganginjani ngisemncane.
Oh, how I was while I was young.
Ngoba umthetho lo.
Because that is the law.
Ukuthi ke into noma umuntu noma indalo.
For a thing or a human being or creation.
Ayikhiqiza ukufana naye.
To produce after on its kind.
Uyathanda awuthandi.
Whether you like it or not.
Lo mhlaba ubuswa imithetho.
This earth is being ruled or governed by the laws.
Ngisho ama principles.
I am talking about principles.
Yona umthetho ebusa umhlaba.
These are the principles that are governing the earth.
Make wafaka uhlamvu emhlabathini.
Once you have put a seed into the soil.
Make yathola umhlabathi right.
Once it got the right soil.
Imbewu ibulawa umhlabathi right.
The seed is being killed by the good soil.
Make wayidla lo mhlabathi.
Once the soil eaten the seed.
Iyafa.
It dies.
Make yafa.
Once it has died.
Ekufeni kwayo.
In its death.
Kuvuka okukhulu kunayo.
The great thing will rise up from it.
Yabo uma wathatha uhlamvu lomvili.
Once you have taken a seed of a meal, then you put it into the soil.
Luafa.
And it dies.
Make luafa.
Once it has died.
Ekufeni kwalo.
In its death.
Kuphuma ikhwebe ezifo.
There will be plenty of mealies.
Esine elinenhlamvu eziningi.
That got many seeds.
Ingakho Paul ethi akusey mina ophilayo.
There is why Paul is saying I no longer live.
UKristu ophila kimi.
But it is Christ who lives in me.
Ngoba make ngafa.
Because once I have died.
Kodwa uNkulunkulu obvelayo.
There is a godness that will rise up.
Ingakho ethi uNkulunkulu.
There is why God is saying
emthakathakeni bami.
In your weakness.
Ila amandla akhe vela khona.
It's where his power is being shown.
Ekuhlulekeni kwami.
In your failing.
Ila ubukhulu bakhe vela khona.
It's where his greatness is being shown.
Ila umusa wakhe vela khona.
It's where his mercy is shown.
Ngicela ukutshela mntakaba.
Let me tell you my brother.
Uyazi ukuthi indaba kuthi nabantu abamnyama abamnyama ba producer. Abantu abamnyama bampofu ba producer abamnyama bampofu.
Do you know why the black people who are poor are producing black people who are also poor?
Asikusebenzele ukuba mpofu.
We do not work for being poor.
Sikwamkele njengefa.
But we have received it as an inheritance.
Angano miyazwakala yini le?
I don't know whether you hear me. Ngifuna
ngobalekile le.
I want you to hear me because it is very important.
Ubumpofu asibusebenzeli.
The poverty we do not work for.
Sikwamkele njengefa.
We have received it as an inheritance.
Elihambisana nolibofuzo.
That goes together with a DNA.
Ulibofuzo.
The DNA.
Imbewu.
Is the seed.
Ephethe yonke into.
That carries everything.
Iphethe shape.
It carries the shape.
Iphethe ubukhulu.
It carries the greatness.
Iphethe ubanzi.
It's
Iphethe umbala.
It having the color.
Ano miyazwakala.
I don't know whether you hear me.
Imbewu.
The seed.
Iphethe ibala.
Carries the color.
Iphethe ubude nobufishane nobukhulu.
It carries the length, the height and the greatness.
Kodwa mawuyibuka imbewu.
But when you look at the seed.
Ayifani nomkhiqizo ophelele.
It is not as their full production.
Uyayizwa le?
Do you hear that?
Mawubuka umbila ufana nesikhwebu.
When you look at the millet it is not as the
uhlamvu lombili.
The seed of a millet.
Kodwa lo uhlamvu lolu.
But this seed,
yazi lipheteni?
Do you know what it carries?
Luphethe isihlahla.
It carries a tree of millet.
Luphethe ikhwebu zombili.
It carries a lot of millet.
Liphethe umbala wesihlahla.
It carries the color of the tree.
So mangabe wenze show ukuthi imbewu imsulwa,
if you have made sure that the seed is pure.
Lento engikhuluma ibalekile.
What I'm speaking is very important.
Umbolothi ngitheni ngithe sizoya kwikusasa.
Remember what I have said. I said we'll go to our tomorrow.
Kuyofanele sidedele izolo.
We'll have to let go of our yesterday.
Sizokwazi ukuba kwikusasa.
So that we'll be able to be in our tomorrow.
Ngiyakholwa ukuthi angigijimi kakhulu. Ningilandela kahle.
Do you hear me?
Yabona uma ube nesiqinisekiso ukuthi imbewu imsulo.
If you have an assurance that your seed is pure.
Nento ezophuma lakho izophuma nobumsulo.
Therefore what will come from the seed will come pure.
Inhloso kaNkulunkulu ngaleyo mbewu izophelela njengoba injalo.
The intent of God of that seed will be complete.
Ngiqonda ukuthini?
What am I meaning?
Angiyenze kanje le ndaba.
Let me put this way.
USathane wahlakanipha.
Devil was very clever.
UNkulunkulu wakhuluma noAdam noEva.
God spoke to Adam and Eve.
What is alalani nande?
He said give birth and replenish and conquer the world.
Ubuse.
And rule it.
Ugcwalise.
And replenish it.
Wesethu uSathane nginomsebenzi.
Then the devil said I've got job.
Angeke ngiyobonakalisa imbewu.
Let me go and corrupt the seed.
Ngoba make yaphuma imbewu.
Because once the seed came out.
Kwaphuma inzalo.
And the offspring.
Ka Adam beno Eva.
Of Adam and Eve.
Yaphuma kubona imsulwa.
Came out from them pure.
Ngizohluleka ukuyibamba.
I will fail to hold it.
Ngoba ngiyobe sengilwa noAdam.
Because I will be fighting with Adam.
Bese ngilwa nenzalo kaAdam.
And fighting with the descendants of Adam.
Mangabe ngingcolise kaAdam.
If I am corrupting the seed of Adam.
Uzohlakanipha ubani uAbel noma uKhayini.
Then Cain will be wise.
Abel and Cain.
Abel and Cain will be wise.
So ngizohluleka ukubabamba ngoba bazothi lente ehlula ubaba thina sivume ukuthi sihlule.
So I will fail to withhold them because they will say what my father failed we won't allow us to fail.
Nezo lento ngishoyo.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Wayese tu Satane.
Then devil said,
angihlakaniphe.
Let me be clever.
Angihambe ngiyolwa.
Let me go and fight.
Angihambe ngiyongcolisa.
Let me go and corrupt.
Ngingcolisa izukulwane zonke ezayo.
And defile all the generations that are coming.
Eshangizwa ngiyanezwe Satan.
You are not hearing me.
Ngithi mina wathi uSatan.
Satan said,
Ngizodinga abafana abawu 3, insizwe ezu 3. Listen, this was all three, right?
These are the three young men.
What is Satan?
Satan said,
Unkulunkulu ukhulume noAdam.
God has spoken to Adam.
What is alalani nani?
He said, I give birth and replenish.
Wamnikeza imbewu.
Then he gave him a seed.
Ukuthi akazalo kufana naye.
To give birth after his own kind.
Mangabe unqobo Adam.
If he is a victor,
uzozala unqobo.
He will give birth to a victor.
Mangabe isicebo Adam.
If he is wealthy,
uzokwehlisa ifa lakhe lebucebi endodaneni.
He will bring down his wealthiness to his son.
Listen, these are all three, right?
These are the three young men.
What is Satan?
Satan said,
Unkulunkulu ukhulume noAdam.
God has spoken to Adam.
What is alalani nani?
He said, I give birth and replenish.
Wamnikeza imbewu.
Then he gave him a seed.
Ukuthi akazalo kufana naye.
To give birth after his own kind.
Mangabe unqobo Adam.
If he is a victor,
uzozala unqobo.
He will give birth to a victor.
Mangabe isicebo Adam.
If he is wealthy,
uzokwehlisa ifa lakhe lebucebi endodaneni.
He will bring down his wealthiness to his son.
Mabe enokuphila okuchichimayo Adam.
If he got an abundant life,
uzodlulisela ukuphila kwakho.
He will pass it on to his son,
abantwana bakhe,
then his kids
ngeke balwele,
won't fight
ukuba nophila,
to have life.
Ngeke balwele,
they won't fight
ukuba nemali,
to have money.
Ngeke balwele,
they won't fight for
ukuba nakho
konke, to have everything,
ngoba vese banakho,
because they already have.
Wabo,
their work or job
multiply,
is to multiply what is already existing. Do you hear what I'm saying? Then Satan came. He said, my friend, come. Do you know that God is playing with you? I won't speak about Eve, but I'm talking about the head. Eat.
Oh, mangithi akedle lo, ngeke azadle unekhanda eliqinile, indoda inekhanda eliqinile.
If I'm saying to this one, eat, he wants because they are stubborn.
What don't you eat?
Then he took Eve.
Engekho Adam.
Without Adam.
Whatever spread.
He said, Eve, let us complete everything.
Idla yonke into.
It's everything. You are not like God. Once you ate, you'll be like him. He never gave her an opportunity to go and share the matter with Adam. He said, finish.
Hello? Because
if they were both, they will rise each
other.
Why I'm saying that?
It's because
Eve came
again.
He came to Job. He said, insult your God and die. I'm telling you, the spirit of Eve came to
Job.
Now it was the wife of
Job
and said, insult God and die. Do what God does not want so that you will die. Then Job said, you speak like a foolish woman. You think that we'll receive only the good from the Lord. Adam is supposed to say like that and say, we are like God. Not that if we eat, it is the food that will cause us to be like God. We are like him. We are created and made like him. There is nothing that will add to be like God. There's nobody who can do something that will cause him to be like God. It's because we were created to be like him. There is nothing that you can add to be like God. Even if you can live right, even if you can do
right
thing, the righteousness of nature, it's like it is the God grace that has made you to be like him. Then Eve was carrying something and said, just imagine, he was already eating the apple, then he gave
him.
Then it was impossible to ask him, why have you eaten something that God said you mustn't eat? They sinned. Then God came. Did you eat? What caused the Lord to see that he had eaten? Because he never saw him in the place where he left him at. You lose your position if you have sin in God. The first question that God asked him, he said, Adam, where are you? Did he ever ask him before? Then second, he said, did you eat? By the time God cursing him because of sin, do you know where it went wrong? The seed was cursed. The seed was also cursed. Everything that was in Adam. Did you hear what Apostle Sherwin said?
Abundance ikuwena.
He said that the abundance is within
when
you.
Kufanele uyikhiphe.
You must the one who must bring
manje,
it out.
Imbewu yayikuyena Adam.
Now the seed was in Adam.
Yayik Adam.
It was in Adam.
So why say why uNkulunkulu ngesikhathi emqalekisa?
When God was cursing him.
Wamqalekisa nembewu yakhe.
He also cursed the seed that was in him.
Ingakho bathi mabethola abantwana.
That is why when they gave birth to kids.
Abantwana abaphuma nesiqalekiso.
Their children came out with the curse.
Abasithole.
That they received from their parents.
Abazali.
While their parents was being cursed. I don't know whether you hear me. When they came out, they grow up. And the one was a sower. Then the other one was a shepherd.
Bazondana.
Then they hate each
Babulalana.
Other. They kill each other. Why did they kill each other? It's because of the curse.
Isidlula lento ayisadluli nesibusiso esiphelele. Isidlula nesibusiso esicontaminated.
This thing does not pass on with a full blessing, but it passed on with a blessing that is contaminated.
Uyazi isibusiso esi esingcolisekile.
Do you know the blessing that is being defiled?
Aqamile. Ayiqamile lento le yesiqalekiso kodwa manje ikotela esibusisweni la sibusiso sikhona nayo ikhona.
This thing of curse is not clear, but it is hanging on the blessing.
Ayibonakalanga kuyena uAdam.
It was never sown in Adam.
Kodwa yabonakala kubantwana bakhe.
But it was seen in their children.
Ngoba uAdam wadlulisela ifa.
Because Adam has passed on the inheritance,
into ayona,
something that he was,
wayidlulisa,
and pass it on.
Ngoba vese,
because
uthiwe zalala nani,
it was said that you need to give birth and
no
multiply and replenish the earth.
Ngamanye amazwi uthi mayikhipha yena,
in other words, when he is bringing out,
ukhipha isibusiso esinesiqalekiso,
he is bringing out the blessing with a curse.
Masifika la,
when it comes.
Isibusiso.
The blessing.
Sifika sino 20% wesiqalekiso no 80% wesibusiso.
It comes with a 20% of a curse and 80% of a blessing.
Siyenza ukuthi impilo ingapheleli.
It makes the life not to be complete.
Masingena la.
Once it enters there.
Siyadlula.
It is being passed on.
Ubona ukuthi u 20% isiqalekiso isibusiso so 80%.
Remember that the curse is 20% and the blessing is 80%.
Ngale sikhathi siqhubeka.
As it is continuing. It goes to this side.
Isona sesu 8.
It is the curse that is
80%.
Now the blessing is 20%.
Yini ku chapter 6? Ngithi chapter 6 mangaphosisi. Eyenza ukuthi uNkulunkulu umhlaba awumboze ngamanzi abulale wonke umuntu.
What do you think that caused God in chapter 6 to cover the earth with water and
ngoba isono nesiqalekiso sanda ngamandla kunesibusiso esasirelizwe kuqala.
Because the sin and the curse increases mightily than the blessing that was released firstly.
Chapter 11.
In chapter 11,
kwavela olunye uhlobo.
Then there came another kind.
Ngoba isiqalekiso sihlale sivunda, sihlale siqhamuka ngeindlela zonke.
Because the curse is always comes in always.
Yakwazi ukuvunda.
Do you know being fatal?
Ukuvunda kuqhamuka noma yikuphi.
It comes wherever.
Ungafaka ukudla kwakho esikafutini.
You can put your food into
a
lunch box, then you close.
Emva kwesonto ukuvalela.
After a week you have closed it. You will find a mold. I don't know whether you hear me.
So
the corruption increases. And it goes on. The demons wanted to appear.
Chapter 11.
When we come to chapter 11, the demons
before chapter 11,
they slept with human beings. Then there was people who was called Anak. Who was giants. They were very long in such a way that people were. They were being called Anak.
They said
that Goliath came from that generation. That development of corruption and of sin. It goes on. And then it covers the blessing.
I hope you enjoyed what you heard so far. Time is against us. It was not enough to cover the whole sermon where Dr. Sonia was preaching. But if you want your copy, you can phone our offices. The information is on the screen and we will gladly forward that DVD to you. But we can't close this program without praying for you. But before we pray for you, we would like to ask you, our partners, to pray for us. Even praying for us and supporting us with your finances. Because if we want to take this profound message, we need finances to be able to take it to the ends of the world. But before we close, can I ask you to receive Jesus Christ as your Savior? Because it all begins there. To change your DNA, you need to receive Jesus to be your Savior. If you want to do that decision now, you can say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, come into my heart. I receive you as my Lord and Savior. Forgive me all of my sins in Jesus' name. And if you have prayed that prayer, I want to assure you that you are a new creation in Christ. All things have passed away. Behold, new things have become over your life. We will ask Dr. Swane to pray for you. Just hold the screen if you can and hold where you have pain, or just put your hand on your chest and receive by faith in the name of Jesus.
We want Jesus Christ to sanctify your DNA through his blood. We want him to change you, to heal you, to deliver you, even from all chronic diseases that are in your life and in your body. His blood is powerful to cleanse anything. By his stripes, you are going to be healed. Let me pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke that cancer. I rebuke that HIV and AIDS. I rebuke that this disease, that blindness, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Amen. I speak life. I speak healing. I speak deliverance right now. Amen. I heal you and I deliver you from those spirits that are binding, oppressing you, destroying your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, I speak life and I release this life to be in abundance over your life. Your life will never be the same again. In the name of Jesus, I sanctify your DNA through the blood of Jesus that is not contaminated, but that speaks better than the Abel's blood. In the name of Jesus, I speak over you. Today, your life will never be the same Amen. Again. In the name of Jesus, I declare it is done. It is completed in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you. Please write to us and tell us what God is doing for you and through this program as we are teaching your life. We will be encouraged to hear your testimony of what God has helped you through the teaching and demonstration and all that we are doing, and keep on supporting us all the way. Be blessed.
Be blessed. We love you. See you next time. Bye.
Shalom.
Shalom.